anybody about this.
No, we haven't.
Oh, hello, we see you.
But I tell you what, Andy, here isn't going to wait for anybody. And another terrific entrance there, really superb. And you can see what a slick machine, 1955, right through to 1993, so an enormous number of pilots. So successfully exported.
The Air Force issued a requirement for a new dedicated jet training aircraft, and it was Hunting Percival who developed this from their original piston engine Percival Commons basic training. The prototype took the air in 1954. JPT-3, featuring a more powerful Armstrong Sydney Viper jet engine ejector seats and a redesign of the aircraft. This T-5 South Yemen and Venezuela. Slightly more heavily armed drones in airborne was eventually developed to have the same kind of feeling. Get up into the 300 miles an hour. I reckon one around at about 350 myself, but it's generally cruises at slower speeds than that. Ergonomically not tremendously well designed in the cockpit. What you're seeing here now is a near perfect marriage of both engine and airframe. P-51D with its bubble canopy and six guns, one of the most iconic and potent fighters of all time. And you hear that whistle there, that is the wind going over Gun 4. P-51D is range with incredible two caliber bars. This particular model, a P-51D-20, built in North America, thinking of the facility in California, is codenamed Jumpjack. United States in December 1924, give up to the Air Force and Ricky Kane. Still carries the battle scars to this day, with bullet repairs in several places on the return to the USA, and this aircraft was placed in storage. Yeah, I must have thoroughly enjoyed that. I know.